So, on the heels of announcing the launch of Backstage, our direct-to-publisher solution for the Yahoo DSP, we had a slew of updates last week as we announced partnership integrations with the following: with FreeWheel, the ad server for the CTV inventory, with Magnite's SpringServe, and with Publica by IAS. Announced those all three last week.
So what's behind that plan? The Backstage initiative, it seems to be part of the broader effort to bring publishers directly, brands closer to publisher inventory, cutting out middlemen and things like that. What is this all about?
So it's just expanding upon that, specifically for CTV inventory. Most of the publishers that we work with today, those are the solutions that they're operating their inventory mediation with. So this is a necessary step in order to get that access back from the publisher. Similarly, if you look at what we already had done on many display publishers, that's mostly a pre-bid setup. For CTV, it requires that you work with the leaders in the space, like these three companies.
With CTV, is there a less of a need to sort of undo what we've done over the years because the market's still being established, or is this an effort to get out ahead of what, it became sort of a mess in the display world?
I don't know that we'll ever see the fragmentation that we have in display web, just because there's just not as many webs. I mean, there's never going to be, I shouldn't say never, but right now the number of CTV publishers that an advertiser wishes to work with is nothing in comparison to the vast open web of display web websites. I think the barrier to entry for being a web publisher versus a CTV publisher is just night and day. And I think that's the distinction that I put in. If you look at the relative scale of the supply footprint of where we're actually connected, it's about 100 display web publishers in our Backstage offering versus 40 CTV publishers.
Right.
And that's about the same ratio, that we'd expect given what our advertisers are asking us for, which inventory they're asking for.
And this all seems to fit in with a broader recent, I call it refocusing of Yahoo's ad tech efforts over the past, I don't know, 6 to 8 months. Can you maybe talk about how that all fits together?
Yeah, so up until the Q1 of this year, 2023, Yahoo Advertising operated three distinct ad platforms. We operated a demand side platform, a sell side platform, and a native ad network. And then even under those three distinct platforms, there was a slew of other SSPs and exchanges and DSPs that have been acquired over the years. It became really, really clear to our new leadership team and, our new owners that this fragmented approach of having multiple stacks is just not a way to give focus. So we looked at ourselves and said, where do we have the best traction? And it really was an easy decision when you looked internally and said, well, where are customers actually clamoring for more, adopting and sticking with us? It was the demand side platform. So we made the decision in Q1 to shutter, deprecate, sunset, however you want to call it, the native ad network and the SSP, just because the demand side platform had so much more to offer our customers. Now, what made Backstage so easy, just I might be answering your next question, but to launch is that because we had been operating in business for so long, we had a lot of publisher relationships already. So it made sense for how we would start and prioritize the DSP to have a direct-to-publisher solution.
Okay, and lastly, I don't know if everyone in the space realizes that Yahoo is pushing further into CTV overall. Can you maybe talk about how this fits in and what's the overall plan there?
One of the best parts about being, named Yahoo is because there's such a great brand affinity for the consumer brand, but it's not a CTV brand. And so it outside of the DSP customer base, yeah, I do feel like we need to do a better job of educating. CTV has been the biggest format growth for our platform for years now. It's not just a 2023 thing. I mean, you go back 3, 4 years now, our advanced TV, CTV footprint, we have the largest household addressable supply footprint of all DSPs. We've got a slew of direct data and measurement integrations with companies like DirecTV, Vizio, Samba TV. Our customers have been adopting ATV with us for years now. And so it was only natural for us to make sure when we launched Backstage that CTV was a huge part of it. It was honestly a requirement. We would not launch Backstage without any investment on the side.